Welcome you all. This is Adarsh Vidyalaya online chemistry class. Standard 10th, Unit 11, Carbon and its compounds, Session 1, Introduction.
What is chemistry? Yes, chemistry is a branch of science that studies atoms and molecules along with their properties. All matter is composed of atoms and molecules. There are five main branches of chemistry, that is organic chemistry, inorganic chemistry, physical chemistry, biochemistry, analytical chemistry. So many chemical reactions are constantly take place around us. Our human body also containing so many chemical reactions. For example, digestion of food, movement of muscle. All body activities involve chemical reaction. So many chemical reactions also takes place around us also. Okay, photosynthesis. Photosynthesis means what, ma? Yes, the plant convert water, sunlight and carbon dioxide into glucose and oxygen. That is also one of the chemical reaction. Soap and detergent, that is used for hygienic work using a chemical process, that is known as emulsification. And then the preparation of soap and detergent, the process name is saponification. So many chemical reaction is takes place around us. Now we are going to study about organic chemistry. Organic chemistry is a chemistry of carbon, an element that forms strong chemical bond to other carbon atom as well as too many other elements like hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen and the halogens. Because of its versatility in forming covalent bond, more than a million carbon compounds are known. Normally, all these compounds are made up of covalent bond. These compounds are called as organic compounds. In this lesson, you will learn about carbon compounds. So, organic chemistry means is simply the study of carbon compounds. Organic chemistry is important because it is the life science. And all the life related chemical reaction is based on organic chemistry. Organic chemistry initially involved the study of the compound that is would be obtained from living organism. Nowadays, just 1.5 million known inorganic compounds only, but more than 7 million different organic compounds are known. This large number of organic compounds arises from the unique property of carbon. That is fully depending upon the carbon. Now we are going to discuss about general characteristics of organic compounds and classification of organic compounds based on the pattern of carbon chain. First topic, general characteristics of organic compounds. First characteristic, organic compound have a high molecular weight and a complex structure. Depending upon the atoms are present in it, that is having different molecular weight and the structure is complex in nature. Second property, they are mostly insoluble in water. All the compounds are organic, so normally that is insoluble in water, but readily soluble in organic solvents. You are well known, ether, carbon tetrachloride, toluene, carbon disulfide, these are the some organic solvents. So, organic compounds dissolve in organic solvent to form non-aqueous solutions. Next characteristic, they are highly inflammable in nature. What do you mean by inflammable? Yes, the material easily catch fire. Highly inflammable liquid is petrol. Okay. Normally, all the organic compounds are highly inflammable in nature. That means that substance are easily catch fire. Next character, organic compounds are less reactive compared to inorganic compounds. That means the reaction involving organic compound proceeding at a slower rate. Normally the reaction is takes place very slow reactions. That means organic compounds are less reactive. Next, mostly all the organic compounds form covalent bonds in nature. Covalent bond means that is one of the chemical bond that involves the sharing of electron pairs between atoms. These electron pairs are known as shared pair of electrons or bond pair electrons, and the stable balance of attractive and repulsive force between atoms when they are sharing electrons to forming a covalent bond. Covalent bond means mutual sharing of electrons, otherwise equal sharing of electron pairs. Next character, they have lower melting point and boiling point compared to inorganic compounds. Why? Yes, because of covalent bond. The intermolecular force between the covalent compounds are very weak. Covalent compounds are normally held together by weak intermolecular force. So, lower heat is capable for breaking the intermolecular force. Therefore, the melting and boiling point of covalent bond is very low. That covalent bond is present in organic compound. So, normally, organic compounds are lower melting point and boiling point compared to inorganic compounds. Another one important characteristic is organic compounds are exhibit isomerism. Isomerism means same molecular formula, different structural formula. That means differ in their physical properties and chemical properties also. Okay, why? Because of structure is different, same molecular formula. So, organic compounds are exhibit isomerism. Next, they are volatile in nature. That means the substance is easily vaporized. Vaporized means turns into gas or vapor. Another one property is organic compounds can be prepared in laboratory. That is also synthetically we are able to prepare. These are the some general characteristics of organic compounds. Next topic, classification of organic compounds based on the pattern of carbon chain. If all the carbon atoms in the chain are connected by single bond, the compound is called as saturated. If one or more double bond or triple bond is exist between the carbon atom, then the compound is called as unsaturated. For example, first compound, all the bonds are single bond, so that is saturated. Second compound, one double bond is present, therefore that is unsaturated compound. So what is the difference between saturated and unsaturated hydrocarbons? Now we are going to study about that. If your compound is saturated hydrocarbon, that means the carbon atoms are linked to each other only by single covalent bond. Suppose unsaturated hydrocarbon means the carbon atoms is present not only a single bond, any one double bond or triple bond also present. Saturated hydrocarbon contain only a single covalent bond. unsaturated hydrocarbon containing carbon-carbon double bond or triple bond also. Saturated hydrocarbons are normally chemically less reactive, but unsaturated hydrocarbons chemically more reactive. Saturated hydrocarbons involve for substitution reaction, but unsaturated hydrocarbons are involved for addition reaction. How will you find saturated and unsaturated compound? One test is there. That is, take a given sample solution in a test tube. Add a few drops of bromine water to it. That is, stand for some time. After that, 5 to 10 minutes. If the given compound is unsaturated, it will be decolorized. If your substance is saturated, do not decolorize bromine water. That means, take a given sample solution in a test tube. Add 1 or 2 drops of bromine water to it. Bromine water normally brown color. So, add a few drops of bromine water and observe any characteristics change in color. If your substance is unsaturated, the bromine water is readily decolorized. Brown color bromine water is converted into colorless. Suppose your substance is saturated, do not decolorize bromine water. That is the identification test for saturated and unsaturated organic compound. So, organic chemistry is a chemistry of carbon-containing compounds. The carbon atoms presented in organic compounds mostly linked with carbon-carbon covalent bond. Normally, fully that is made up of covalent bonds. Covalent bonds means sharing of electrons between the atoms. So, organic compounds are broadly classified into two types. One is acyclic or open chain compound. Another one is cyclic or closed chain compound. Acyclic or open chain means the compounds are, that means carbon-carbon atoms are linked in a linear pattern to form a chain. Cyclic or closed chain compound means organic compounds in which the chain of carbon atom is closed or encyclic in nature. So that is called a cyclic compound. If the chain is containing only carbon atom, that is called as carbocyclic compound. Carbocyclic compound means that is containing only carbon atoms. Heterocyclic compound means if the carbon chain containing carbon as well as other element also. Other element means that is oxygen, nitrogen, sulfur, etc. So that is called as heterocyclic compound. Carbocyclic means only carbon atoms presented in the carbon chain. Heterocyclic means ring shape at the same time that is containing other elements. Other elements means oxygen, nitrogen, sulfur, etc. Carbocyclic compound also classify into two types. One is alicyclic compound, another one is aromatic compound. Alicyclic compound means that is containing one or more carbocyclic ring which may be saturated or unsaturated. Okay ma? Alicyclic means that is containing one or more carbocyclic ring. Carbocyclic ring means only carbon chain is present. Only carbon atom is present in a ring. Okay. Aromatic compounds means that is formed by one or more benzene ring. That means that is containing alternate double bond between the carbon atom. Open chain is classified into two types. One is saturated, another one is unsaturated. Already we have studied this. Saturated means the compound is containing only carbon-carbon single bond. All the bonds are made up of single bond only. Unsaturated means at least one or more double bond or triple bond is present between the carbon atoms. That type of compound is called as unsaturated. This is the general classification of organic compound. Tell me, ma, what type of compound this? Yes, carbon plus oxygen also present in the link, so that is heterocyclic compound. What ma? This is heterocyclic compound. Why that is called as heterocyclic compound? Here the chain is containing carbon atom and also oxygen atom. This is ma? This is carbocyclic compound. Why that is called as carbocyclic compound? Yes, the chain is containing only carbon atoms, but that is in cyclic format, so that is a carbocyclic compound. This is, yes, this is aromatic compound. Aromatic compound means this is actually a benzene ring. Ring containing alternate double bond between the carbon atom, that is called as benzene ring. This is aromatic compound. Once again, ma, this is heterocyclic compound. This is carbocyclic compound, especially this is alicyclic compound. This is also a carbocyclic compound, especially aromatic compound. Thank you.